Harvey Weinstein hit with new criminal charges in New York as the Manhattan District Attorney's Office prepares to retry the former movie mogul following the reversal of his rape conviction. Jurors found Weinstein guilty on rape charges in 2020. But the New York Court of Appeals threw out the conviction in April, finding Weinstein did not get a fair trial because a judge improperly allowed testimony by accusers. He was not formally charged with assaulting. Prosecutors said in July they were investigating additional violent sexual assaults allegedly committed by Weinstein after more women agreed to testify against him. Weinstein, who underwent emergency surgery Sunday, was not in court when the new indictments were announced. U.S. Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump ruling out another debate against Democratic rival Kamala Harris ahead of the November 5 election. On Truth Social, Trump said all details of the problems caused by Harris and U.S. President Joe Biden were already discussed in the first and second debates. He also claimed polls had him winning the showdown despite several surveys showing it was Harris who had the edge. Republican donors and Trump advisors who spoke to Reuters also agree that Harris won the debate, largely because Trump was unable to stay on message. Harris, meanwhile, is raring to have another go at Trump.
Could not be more important. Over 200 people who worked for President George H.W. Bush, President George W. Bush, John McCain, and Mitt Romney have endorsed me for president. Former Vice President Dick Cheney and Congresswoman Liz Cheney are supporting me as well. We have a duty as citizens to put country above partisanship and defend our Constitution.
Malaysian authorities rescue more than 400 children from Islamic Charity homes. The minors, aged between 1 and 17, were rescued after reports were filed alleging neglect, abuse, sexual harassment, and molestation. A total of 171 adults were arrested, including Islamic religious teachers, during coordinated raids on 20 premises across two states. The homes were all run by Global Ikhwan Services and Business, which has been linked to a banned Al-Akram religious sect. The business group has denied the sexual abuse allegations and says it did not manage the charity homes. Pope Francis celebrates the last mass of his 12-day trip across Southeast Asia and Oceania. More than 50,000 people filled the national stadium to attend the first papal mass in Singapore since 1986. Earlier on Thursday, the pontiff urged political leaders in Singapore to seek fair wages for the country's million-plus lower-paid foreign workers. Many of the migrant workers come from nearby countries, including the Philippines.
Like hopeful, and like I can express my feeling, like happy and very happy. Because look, this time I'm still shaking. Yeah, because one of the cardinal from Myanmar, I taking photo and then he blessed me.
The Pope's tour included stops in Indonesia, Papua New Guinea, and Timor-Leste. He is scheduled to return to Rome today.